Man has turned to the sea and to the life above and below it for adventure. Not content with surface thrills, man also invades the depths equipped with a diving hat, weight boots, dive suit, endless courage and curiosity as he moves into this airless fluid world. Join us as we explore the depths on this episode of Diving into the Past.
Hello. In earlier videos, we have seen the Helium recirculators that Bob Kirby built for Associated divers as the company tried to play catch-up against DIVCON and general offshore divers who already had Helium capability and were taking market share from Associated in the diving off the coast of Santa Barbara. Today, I'm showing you the next step in Bob Kirby's design of Helium recirculators. We're also going to revisit the DIVCON integral canister helium recirculator because historically these two are connected. The first DIVCON integral canister helmets had proved their worth, with Murray Black and Walt Thompson both completing working dives to 525 feet in 1964. The two original helmets were so successful that DIVCON had two more built, also on Morse shells. These next two were slightly different in that they only use one soda sorb canister, not two like the original pair. As you can see in the photo, the canister housing at the back of the bonnet of these two helmets is much shorter. As seen in the earlier videos, both of the original DIVCON integral canister recirculators have survived intact. I have not yet seen either of the second two helmets, but Santa Barbara Maritime Museum had photos of one of them, which showed that numerous parts of the recirculator system had been removed. DIVCON's Murray Black also wanted recirculators that a diver could put on and take off by himself. These helmets were to be used by a diver working out of a diving bell without the assistance of a tender. The DIVCON integral canister helmets were far too bulky to pass through the hatch of a diving bell, so Black sought the assistance of Bob Kirby. Black felt that Kirby's design of recirculator would allow a diver to pass through the bell hatch. He then went to visit Kirby to discuss a specific design he wanted Kirby to build. Black wanted the diver to be able to put on and take off the recirculator bonnet himself. There was to be no tender in the bell with the diver. In his book, Hard Hat Divers Wear Dresses, Bob Kirby recalls Black's instructions as, quote, "I need two metal plates with holes in them, soldered onto the helmet's neck ring. Inside the bell, I'll have two large screen door latches. I'll drop these two hooks into the holes on my hat so I can screw myself into the rig. Don't worry, I can swim like mad in heavy gear." So in practice, once back inside the bell, the diver would unlock his helmet, place the two metal plate holes on the screw door latches and turn his body 1/8 of a turn to his left, thereby disengaging the bonnet from the breastplate. A lot easier for me to say than for a diver to do. Black also wanted the gas controls to be on a US Navy Mark V style air control valve and whip, not located on the bonnet as Kirby had designed. Kirby built four of these Kirby DIVCON recirculators for Black, and some of them at least were sent to be used in the North Sea. At least two of these Kirby DIVCON recirculators have survived intact and have been located. One is shown in Leon Lyon's book, Helmets of the Deep, and the other is the one we have here. Back in the early 1990s, my very good friend Skip Dunham had it in his collection. I then acquired it for my collection and much later released it into a private collection that specializes in helmets designed and built by Bob Kirby. I've yet to meet any diver who actually dove one of these Kirby DIVCON helmets out of a diving bell. I'm sure it would have been an unforgettable experience. Murray Black paid Bob Kirby $1,300 cash for each of these four DIVCON Kirby recirculators. And with that money, Bob Kirby hired Bev Morgan. In a very short time, Bob and Bev became partners, and thus, in Santa Barbara, California, in late 1965, the Kirby Morgan Company was founded.